Yo, what is up, guys? Stellboy here, aka Blue Collar Sports TV. Hopefully you guys are doing well. If you're new here, smash that like, hit subscribe, all of that good stuff. So Conor Benn destroys Chris Van Heerden in the second round. Now, going into this fight, I felt that this was relatively predictable in regards to the winner. You know, I wasn't particularly happy with Chris Van Heerden as an opponent. You know, wrong side of 30, had one round in about 2.5 years, so he's been super inactive. Wrong side of 30, I wasn't really sold on Chris Van Heerden as an opponent. However, you know, all Conor Benn can do is do what he needs to do, and when you fight a guy like this, you need to blow him out. You need to get him out of there quick time, and that's exactly what Conor Benn did. Obviously, Chris Van Heerden, a southpaw, Conor Benn orthodox. First round was actually quite competitive. Conor Benn came out applying pressure, as he does, trying to fight out of that crouch, coming over the top with his overhand right, loading up with that left hook, and he was catching Chris Van Heerden in the first round. But Chris Van Heerden was coming back with some good work from his lead hand, so counter jabs and counter right hooks out of that southpaw stance. And, you know, he was timing Conor Benn in the exchanges on a couple of occasions. Conor Benn clearly won the first round, but Chris Van Heerden, you know, he showed a couple of signs of life. You know, he threw a couple of decent counters which caught Conor Benn, but Conor Benn was in charge in round one. He landed the harder shots. He was dictating the fight. He was the aggressor. And round two... was where the fight ended. Once again, Conor Benn came out very aggressive. One thing I will say, I felt that Chris Van Heerden looked pretty skittish in this fight, a little bit nervous. I felt that from the first bell. But yeah, second round, Conor Benn came out aggressive again. And towards the beginning of the second round, Conor Benn connected with a overhand right on the chin of Chris Van Heerden, which hurt Van Heerden. Conor Benn then followed up with a series of punches, including a left hook which landed, and it culminated in a chopping right hand to basically the temple. Chris Van Heerden went down, and that was all she wrote. So yeah, I mean, it's one of those ones. Conor Benn did what he needed to do against an older, overmatched opponent. What more can I say? It's becoming a bit of a theme now with Conor Benn. I'm listening to the post-fight interview now with Conor Benn and Eddie Hearn. And Eddie Hearn is saying a step up is now needed. He mentioned names like Danny Garcia, Keith Thurman, and Mikey Garcia. If Conor Benn were to fight one of those guys next, I would be very happy. But, you know, Eddie Hearn being Eddie Hearn, he also mentioned Adrian Broner along with those names. And to me, listen, bullshit aside, flashing lights aside, hype aside, one-liners aside, sound bites aside, Adrian Broner is absolutely washed. He's shot. He's been shot for a long time. So Adrian Broner, yes, it's a high-profile fight, but is it a good fight? Not really. Broner is done. I mean, Broner lost his last fight and got a gift decision. Again, I forgot the guy's name. He was that irrelevant. So Conor Benn versus Adrian Broner, it's just more of the same. Conor Benn's been fighting faded, washed-up guys. It's time for a step-up now. It's time for a step-up. Some, you know, a guy with ambition, a guy who can punch a little bit maybe. Something interesting. Believe it or not, during the post-fight interview, they brought up Amir Khan for some reason to get in the ring and, you know, have a little discussion with Conor Benn. And Conor Benn was begging for the fight. He was trying to get Amir Khan to accept the fight. So, listen, We can't have that. Amir Khan is done, as we know, as we saw in the Kell Brook fight. I've got no interest in Conor Benn fighting these washed up guys. I want to see Conor Benn fight somebody with ambition. I'm not even asking him to fight a top 10 guy. David Avanesian would suffice. Even someone like Michael McKinson, I'd be happy with. Just somebody who's not fucking shot, who's not the wrong side of 30, somebody who brings something to the table, not looking for just a payday, you know? That's what I'm looking for now from Conor Benn. It's time to find out now what this guy has in the locker, and you're not going to find that out against guys like Chris Algieri or Chris Van Heerden, guys who are washed, looking for one last payday. You're not going to find that out. he needs to fight guys with ambition, you know, guys who are coming to win. So yeah, I mean, I feel like Conor Benn now, in my opinion, yes, he's exciting in the ring, but the way his career is being moved is incredibly boring right now. I'm looking for that big fight, that fight where I can say, damn, I wasn't expecting that. Now I'm happy with this fight. That's what I'm looking forward to saying. I'm sick of talking about Conor Benn and being disappointed or just being, yeah, whatever, you know. But yeah, I mean, listen, Conor Benn, he is what he is. Is he exciting? Yes. Does he have a fan-friendly style? Yes. But honestly, I have no idea how good he is. I think he's got a lot of flaws. Do I class him as a blue chip prospect like Jerron Ennis or Virgil Ortiz? No. That's not to say he's bad, but I just can't put him on that level, to be honest with you. So yeah, I mean, it is what it is. You know, every Conor Benn post-fight review is the same. Share your thoughts below. How do you think Conor Benn looked? And who do you want to see him fight next? Are you gunning for the Avanesian fight? The Michael McKinson fight? Maybe Danny Garcia? Mikey Garcia? Do you actually want to see the Adrian Broner fight? Share your thoughts below. Tell me what you guys think. Who do you want to see Conor Benn fight next? And, share your thoughts below. Peace.